Hi everyone, today we will jump to digital systems. Yeah, this is an example of digital system. The term digital signal is limited to only a few possible values. In general, digital signals are represented by two voltages on a wire, and it is represented as zeros and ones that we call binary. So the two possible voltages on a wire are 0 volts, that is a binary 0, and a 5 volt, that is a binary 1. Sometimes these are also represented as true and false or low and high. Actually, there can be more complicated digital signals using these zeros and ones. For example, 001 or 101 or 111. Actually, there is no limit to how many binary digits we can use in a digital signal. It's time for the intro. So here we have a digital signal. Here you can see the voltage is always changing between two values, that is 5 volt and 0 volts. It is jumping from 5 volt to directly to 0 volts and from 0 volt directly to 5 volt. So here we have a 5 volt, here we have a 0 volt, here we have a 5 volt, here we have a 0 volt. We earlier learned that these 5 volt and 0 volt can be represented using binary numbers, ones and zeros. So a 5 volt will be a binary 1 and the 0 volt will be a binary 0. So here we have a binary 1, here we have a binary 0, here we have a 1, 0, 1. While analog electronics uses voltages that often change smoothly from one value to another, here you can see the voltage is not jumping directly to 0 after a high voltage or something like that. It is always changing smoothly. It has some freedom or something like that. So it can be used to make a light dimmer or brighter. Now let's talk about noise. So what is a noise? What a silly question he is asking. It's not that silly. In digital electronics, noise is something sort of an unwanted voltage or unwanted disturbance in your signal. For example, if you are injecting some sort of noise into your audio signal, for example, a music, it would feel terrific because there will be so many glitches and cuts and other sorts of problems. Stop it! Let's be silent for some time. Enjoy the silence. Enough! We cannot make everyone silent for every time. So what to do? The digital systems have made a way. They set up some sort of threshold values. So all the noise that will be under this threshold value will be ignored by them. I'll show you. In digital systems, if we inject a noise, there will not be so much problem. But in analog electronics, if we inject a noise, there will be difference in the output. It is because we are setting some sort of threshold values for our digital systems. So for better noise immunity, we want lots of noise margin. Here the noise margin is 2.5 volt. For binary 1, it is from 5 volt to 2.5 volt. And for binary 0, it is from 0 volt to 2.5 volt. Here I chose 2.5 volt as noise margin because it has better noise immunity than any other values. But it is not also not enough. This is the problem of noise. Here you can see the noise is superimposed on top of our digital signal. Here we actually wanted a logical zero, but because of the noise is too high, it crossed the noise margin, and here we have a logical one. So it is a great problem. So for getting better noise immunity, we should stick that digital devices meet threshold values, and that is called static discipline in digital abstraction. So in digital abstractions, there are mainly two things. First is discretized values, which means zeros and ones, and the next is static discipline, which is digital devices meet voltage thresholds. If a sender sends a pure digital signal like this, sometimes because of the noise is superimposed on top of it, it would look like this. So for getting better noise immunity, we set voltage thresholds. For setting voltage thresholds, first we need to know four other things. That is voltage output low, VOL, voltage output high, VOH, and VIH, that is voltage input high, and VIL, that is voltage input low. So the system can be represented like this. The sender sends a digital signal and it will be received by this receiver. And here we have the voltage input high and here we have the voltage input low. I'll show you how it really works. If you look at the signal, you can see a lot of noise, but it has better noise immunity because we have all these threshold values over here. So even if a noise comes to this region over here, it wouldn't count it as a logical one. This region over here is called forbidden region. It doesn't care. So it has better noise immunity. It is now working in our favor because of the fact that we have all these, we have these voltage thresholds. One thing to remember while setting these threshold values is that you should satisfy the static discipline. I have an example for you. Here, voltage output low is equal to 0.2 volt, voltage input low is equal to 0.5 volt, voltage output high is equal to 5.1 volt, and voltage input high is equal to 4.5 volt. I have represented it over here. It is in another way. So you can see the voltage output low is this one. Voltage output high, voltage input low is this one, and voltage input high is this one. If you look at this thing carefully, you can see our actual voltage is 5 volt, but VOH is greater than 5 volt, it is 5.1 volt. So it is a problem. So here it doesn't satisfy our VOH because our output is less than VOH. So to satisfy it, either the 5 volt should go up or the VOH should go down. So look out for that mistake. So now you understood how to get better noise immunity. Another key to noise tolerance during communication is amplification. I'll talk about it in another video. So now you know how to set the voltage thresholds. So stick to the digital abstraction as well as to this channel. Then your life would be wonderful. Thank you for watching. This is me, Dev Prakash. I'll catch you in the next one.